Hi everyone, through this class we are going to study about two important nonlinear Raman effects, inverse Raman scattering and coherent anti-Stokes Raman scattering. First we consider inverse Raman scattering. We know that Raman scattering is inelastic scattering of photons by molecules. If a photon of energy h nu 0 collide with a molecule which is in higher energy level E2, during their collision, if the molecule jump back to E1 level by emitting h nu m, then the scattered photon, its energy will be equal to h nu 0 plus h nu m, or it is equal to h into nu 0 plus nu m. This is known as Raman anti-Stokes scattering. If this process is inverted, that means if the molecule in lower energy level collide with a photon of energy h into nu 0 plus nu m, this molecule can absorb energy from this photon and can jump to higher energy level E2, then the scattered photon, its energy will be equal to h nu 0. This phenomena is called inverse anti-Stokes Raman effect. The absorption of radiation of frequency nu 0 minus nu m by the molecule would result in decrease in the energy of the scattering molecule by h nu m and emission of radiation of energy h nu 0. This process is inverse Stokes Raman scattering. This complementary effect requires appropriate population of upper state. It is found that absorption at frequencies nu 0 plus or minus nu m can occur only in the presence of very intense radiation of frequency nu 0. The essential requirements for the observation of inverse Raman scattering are the simultaneous irradiation of sample with a giant pulse laser and a strong continuum covering the Stokes and anti-Stokes region. Figure shows one of the experimental arrangements for the observation of inverse Raman scattering. The frequency nu 0 of the giant pulse ruby laser is doubled in this KDP crystal. The second harmonic, that means the doubled frequency nu 0, that is 2 nu 0, it is separated from original nu 0 by this mirror M1. And the second harmonic frequency 2 nu 0, that is used to pump the dye laser. And in dye laser, the optical resonant cavity is formed by a partially reflecting mirror M3 and a fully reflecting mirror M6. The output of the dye laser, that is of frequency nu L, that is directed into the sample using this mirror M2. The output frequency of this ruby laser nu 0 and the output frequency of this dye laser nu L are directed into the sample by using mirror M4 and this M5. The dye laser output is the continuum, which has a width of about 200 cm raised to minus 1. By recording this in a spectrograph, the different portions of the Raman spectrum can be covered depending on the dye and its concentration. Next, we consider coherent anti-Stokes Raman scattering. It is also known as CARS. The coherent anti-Stokes Raman scattering combines the advantages of stimulated Raman scattering and the general applicability of normal Raman scattering. When coherent radiation of frequency nu 1 is mixed with a coherent radiation of another frequency nu 2, where nu 1 is greater than nu 2 in a molecular medium, the coherent radiation of another frequency is generated. Here the generated frequency is nu 3, which is equal to 2 times nu 1 minus nu 2. That we can write it as nu 1 plus nu 1 minus nu 2. And if nu 1 minus nu 2 is nu m, which is the Raman active vibration of the molecule, then nu 3 we can write it as nu 1 plus nu m, which is an anti-Stokes Raman frequency. Here, by fixing the frequency in U1, we can vary the second frequency in U2 in order to get the difference between U1 and U2 as nu m. The radiation produced in this way, it is termed as coherent anti-Stokes Raman scattering or CARS. Thus, CARS is also associated with third order nonlinear susceptibility. A nonlinear mixing of this kind was first discovered by Maker and Terhune in 1963. Figure shows a typical CARS setup where two incident radiations are provided by argon plus laser of wavelength 514.5 nanometer and a dye laser. And this dye laser is a tunable laser. So we can vary the frequency in U2. Here the frequency in U2 is varied in such a way that nu1 minus nu2 is nu m. And this continuous wave dye laser, it is pumped by same argon plus laser. And the frequencies are mixed temporally and spatially within the sample. With the CARS, the conversion efficiency to nu3 is several orders of magnitude than conversion efficiency in normal Raman scattering. The radiations resulting from CARS from a highly coherent collimated beam, whereas in normal Raman scattering, it is incoherent. And in normal Raman scattering, it extends over a solid angle of 4 pi. Since CARS is highly collimated, fluorescence and thermal radiation from hot samples can effectively be filtered by placing a screen with a few millimeter diameter between the detector and the sample, which just passes only the CARS beam. Moreover, no dispersing medium is needed for CARS experiment. The fluorescence-free nature of CARS make it ideal tool for high-resolution spectroscopy studies and analysis of biological samples.